What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min for Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you the new features in Lumion 12. Let's get started. Number 1. Improve Object Library. We all know that Lumion offers thousands and thousands of objects that we can use to populate our scene and show our design in its real-life context. However, Lumion's constantly growing library can sometimes make it difficult to find specific items. But in Lumion 12, the objects library has been improved. When you open the object library, you will see the 3D objects are now organized in what's called object collections. This new feature will help organize the huge Lumion library into neat categories, which makes it a lot easier to navigate through the thousands of objects that Lumion provides. Also, you will notice that each object now has new object tags. When you click on a tag, Lumion will find similar items with that tag, which you can also see that it is inputted automatically here in the search bar. If you type in the tag L12 in the search bar, you'll be able to find all the new objects in Lumion 12, which are also indicated by the blue dot in the upper left corner of each object's thumbnail. With this new feature, you can be assured that you will not miss any amazing object in each new version of Lumion, and you'll now be able to make use of the huge Lumion library to its full potential. Number 2. Surface Decals. In Lumion 12, there's a new object type called Decals. To use it, you can go to the Effects category and click here. This library includes 142 decals that you can use, organized in different categories such as Asphalt Damage, Dirt, Exposed Brick, Road Markings, etc. After you place a decal in the scene, you can select it to make additional changes such as Orientation, Transparency, and Range. If you want to change the size, then you can use the Scale tool. Alternatively, when placing a decal, you can use the L key to change the size however you want. You can also change the color of the decal. This is especially useful for decals such as road markings. There are also additional settings that you can experiment with, such as flipping the decal horizontally and vertically, and blending the different maps of the decal. At this moment, there is no option to add your own decal, but I'm sure Lumion will add it in a future update, similar to how they did it with the displacement feature. Number 3. Character Billboard. Lumion has lots of people entourage that you can use to populate your scene. These include 3D animated people, 3D still people, 2D people, etc. There's a lot of options that you have, but if you want to add custom 2D cutouts, then you can use the new Character Billboard feature. To use it, go to Utilities and select Character Billboard. Now you can place it in your scene, then select it, and click here to load a custom texture. After you have imported the image, you can resize it using the Scale tool. In this case, I use the Lumion 3D Entourage as a reference for the size. With this new feature, you don't have to import a custom surface with a custom image from your 3D software like SketchUp. And the cool thing about a Character Billboard is that it automatically faces the camera no matter where you go. Pretty cool, huh? Number 4. Clip Plane Outline. Lumion has updated the Clip Plane tool to make it look even better. To add a clip plane, go to Utilities and select Clip Plane. And now you can place it in your model. Then you can adjust it however you want, such as refining the position, or select a specific layer to clip. In Lumion 12, you can now add an outline along the edge of the visible geometry that's clipped. And here you can change the color and the width of the outline. This new feature is great for creating 3 to 4 planes like so. Number 5. License Plates. Another new feature that's been added to Lumion 12 is License Plates. To use it, select a car object in your scene, then you can click here to enable License Plates. Now you can choose from a collection of License Plates from 10 different countries, including Australia, China, France, etc., as well as all of the 50 states in the US. You can see that the License Plate also look really good up close, and they're pretty realistic. These license plates are added in both the front and the back of the car. If you've noticed, you can see that this new feature will affect the license plates of all the car objects in your scene, so you won't have to spend time on turning on the license plates for each car. Also, the numbers of the license plates are randomized, which makes each of them unique. Pretty cool, huh? Number 6. Improve Material Workflows. Like in every Lumion update, there are always new material being added to the materials library. However, in Lumion 12, the materials workflow has been updated. In the previous version of Lumion, you could only load the color map, normal map, and displacement map. But if you want to add a map for reflectivity, you had to use Photoshop to combine maps to achieve a more realistic effect. Now in Lumion 12, all of these maps can be added separately. You will see a new input slot for the glossiness map, as well as a slot for the reflectivity map, which can also serve as the alpha or emissiveness map. With this new workflow, the materials in Lumion can now look even more realistic. Number 7. Volumetric Spotlights. Volumetric Spotlight is a new effect that lets you cast a visible beam of light throughout your scene. To use it, go to the photo or movie mode, click on Add Effect, and in the lighting category, you will find the new Volumetric Spotlights effect. Next, you can click on this button to select the lights that you want to apply the effect. Then you can adjust the density, intensity, and falloff. As you can see, the volumetric spotlight effect is a great way to add atmosphere and dimension for a beautiful cinematic ambience. Number 8. Light Temperature. Another improvement for lighting in Lumion is the new Light Temperature feature. Normally, you can control the color of the light using this button here. But now next to the Color tab, you will see a new tab which lets you control the light temperature. Here you can use the presets, which will directly affect the color temperature in Kelvin degrees. On the other hand, if you want a specific temperature, you can type it in here as well. With this new feature, it takes a few seconds to create a perfect lighting ambience for your design. Number 9. Improved Autumn Effect. The Autumn Effect has been improved in Lumion 12. In the previous versions of Lumion, you had to manually adjust the color correction of the leaves to achieve an autumn effect. But in Lumion 12, the Autumn Effect had 3 presets that you can use to quickly change the color of the leaves in your scene. If you want to customize it even more, then you can use these sliders and settings down here. You can combine this new feature with other effects to quickly give your scene an autumn atmosphere. Number 10. Other features. There are also other new features and updates, such as the updated OpenStreetMaps, new context menus, and the Autodesk Format Live Sync feature, etc. And those are the new features in Lumion 12. If you want to learn more, then go to the link in the description box below. That's all for today, guys. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Comment below if you have any questions. Stay inspired, guys, and I'll see you next time.